All right, check out our new sponsor, Greenwood Stocks. They want you to know how to be able to trade stocks and be your own boss and be free to travel the world by making passive income. We all need that passive income from stock market. What are you waiting for? Call or text 281-760-3170. If you didn't catch that, that's on your screen. Or check them out at social media, Greenwood Stocks, and catch them at Gmail, greenwoodstocktrading at Gmail, and the YouTube channel is Greenwood Stocks. Appreciate them for giving me the opportunity. Check them out. We out.
Hey, Steven, man, you really believe that stuff? Oh, man, come on. You really believe that stuff you be saying?
Let's talk about the NBA last night. Appreciate everybody for tapping in. Make sure you check the NBA Talk playlist out for more videos like this. We had the Nets blowing out the Milwaukee Bucks. I thought Milwaukee was going to win, especially when I seen, James Harden go down. But let's talk about it. Don't forget on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, all my social media links, subscription. You can reach out if you want to advertise your business channel. Video request, chop it up. Why did it take me to football scores? So, I turned that shit off when I went live last night. That shit was, they were like 30 points at the half or some shit like that, man. And, Milwaukee just don't know their strengths. All right? You know, the it's a players league, a young players league, and that's the issue, man, that these coaches can't get these players to do what they need to do. You know, Mike Budenholzer should put Middleton and Giannis on the block. You know what I'm saying? You know, post Giannis up, post Middleton up sometimes, and let Giannis work out the post. The lineup I would go with would be Drew at the one. I would have went with DiVincenzo. He got injured, but Drew at the one. I put Middleton at the three. Giannis at the five. I bring in Bobby Portis to play the four. Okay. And probably go with Bobby Forrest to play the two. That would be my primary lineup because I'm going to have Giannis post up every time. If Giannis post up, they have no answer for Giannis. Okay? And that's the issue. Giannis, nigga, you can't shoot free throws. You can't shoot threes. You ain't got a mid-range jumper. Get on the block. And once they start have to collapse on Giannis and double Giannis, he kick it out to Holiday three. He kick it out to Middleton, open three. To me, Giannis ain't got what it take. He ain't improved none. None. You know, he ain't develop a floater. He ain't develop an elbow shot. He ain't develop a mid-range. All the shit he need to do. He ain't develop a hook over the right shoulder, hook over the left shoulder. Even when he posts, it's all about his athleticism. Him spinning hard and dunking. Nigga, do you understand? You need finesse. You need a baby hook. You need a turnaround like Sheet. You know, you need a sky hook like Kareem. You need a baby hook like Shaq. You know, to me, dude, I hate watching the NBA, bro, with niggas like Giannis because he don't do what he need to do. He don't. Him and Drew Holiday in the pick and roll. They sit there and they jacked up 27 threes and only made 8. Brooklyn jacked up 42 threes and made 21. That's 50%. You know, get that big. And they shot 44% for the free throw. They only shot 9 free throws for a game. Well, Brooklyn only shot 7, though. But shit. You know, drive to the bucket. It ain't even about Brooklyn defense. Milwaukee, man, they need to just blow it up, bro. Trey Giannis. But you ain't gonna never win with them. Trade it up, Trey Giannis, Trey Holiday, Trey Middleton. Get your picks back and start over again. Giannis is not good enough to be a playoff performer. He is Julius Randle. He been Julius Randle, and that was Julius Randle's first playoffs. If my memory correct. You know, like I said before, man. To me, it's an abomination of the proclamation in my Don King voice. It's terrible. It's terrible. You can't just take the ball and drive it in the playoffs every time. And that's what Giannis had to do. Get in transition, you know, get a full head of steam, get to the bucket. In the playoffs, it's a half-court game, and the Milwaukee Bucks don't have a half-court motion system. Their system is to jack up threes. Put Giannis at the five. Put Portis at the four. Put Middleton at the three. Holiday and that white boy, McConnell, whatever his name is, at the two. Or Forbes. Make that your lineup. Play inside out. Like Giannis beat Dwight Howard, get a bucket, a Shaq, get buckets. Think about it. If Giannis is shooting 70% off the block, and Brooklyn is shooting 44% from threes, or 44%, excuse me, 50%, they shot 40% from the line. But nigga, shit, let me get Giannis on the block. But Milwaukee done. You know, it's a trash team. It's a trash superstar, Giannis. The most overrated player in the league because he trash. He can't shoot. He Ben Simmons, just more aggressive again. He Ben Simmons. All you can do is drive. No floater, no pitch shot, no post game. Trash. But like I said before, man, Brooklyn, talk about Brooklyn a minute. They too deadly. People talking about Blake Griffin back. This motherfucker 7 points and eight rebounds. How the fuck is Blake Griffin back? That weak ass dunk. Out of here, man. People be killing me. Blake Griffin's back. That motherfucker 7, 8 rebounds for 7 points. How is that superstar status? Kyrie was 22 points, over 50% shooting, 6 assists. You know, KD, damn. Boy, I hate dog season. 32 points, 6 assists, 4 rebounds for KD. They got 10 points off of Mike James off the bench. Other than that, it was a solid game for them. Solid game for them, man. So I ain't got much to say about them. Let's move on. It was another good game. So it got out of the hands of Chris Paul. Kind of woke up. And he spit hot fire. But Nuggets lose 105 to 122. You thought Phoenix, who just had a kind of a quick turnaround, would kind of not be as crisp. But they was. It's a young team for the most part. I had to look at him. They give him that look. Ain't nobody trying to hear that. Down. See what Miles doing? Go to sleep. Boy. Aaron Gordon, he did great D on Devin Booker tonight. He had 18 points, 50% shooting, didn't make a 3-0-3. Jokic said that DeAndre Ayton was the toughest player for him to play against this year. 22-9. Right? Under 50% shooting. Really nothing else to speak of from there other than Jermichael Green getting 10 points off the bench, 11 rebounds. Dallas, Booker still was 8 for 12, but only took 12 shots. Chris Paul, DeAndre Ayton took more shots than Devin Booker. Bridges took the same amount of shots, and Jay Crowder took more shots than him. They're going to have to get Devin Booker free, have move him around. Aaron Gordon is too good of a defender, but 21 points from Booker, 21 points from Chris Paul, 20 points for Aiden, 23 points from Bridges. He was a star in this game, and 14 points for Jay Crowder. Off the bench, then they got 9 from Torrey Craig, 2 for Cam Johnson, 7 for Cameron Payne, 5 for Dario Saric. You about to go in the cage, brother. Nobody want to hear that. But, you know, I wasn't surprised that Denver had a lead, and they seemed to kind of had a little bit of control until the second half. I think Phoenix took the lead, but it's nothing for Phoenix to hold their head down. You know, Porter didn't have his best game. Gordon didn't have his best game. You know, but they didn't play their best game last night. I think, shut up, Zapato, please. He always whining. But, but yeah, I think for Denver, I don't know what happened in the second half. But Aaron Gordon, pretty much, even though to say it's funny, Booker shot 8 for 12 from the field. Aaron Gordon did a great job on Booker. Michael Porter got to take more than 13 shots. I mean, it was a winnable game for them, man. It was. I wouldn't hold my hand, but DeAndre Ayton is playing amazing. DeAndre Ayton is playing amazing, man. He keep playing like this. If Chris Paul get healthy, Chris Paul had 21, 11 assists. I think they're going to be hard to beat. You know what I'm saying? But they're going to be hard to beat, man. I think there's some adjustments for Denver. Kind of reward Aaron Gordon more on the offensive end. Michael Porter got to shoot better. I think Jokic should do better. But, you know what? I think putting Monty Morris in the starting lineup would be better for them. Even though he shot 1 for 10 last night. But I think putting him in the starting lineup would be better for them, man. But other than that, man, we'll see, man. I think it's going to be a good series. I think it goes 7. But if Chris Paul is healthy, I think it could be a wrap, honestly. So we'll see. Don't forget me on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. Reach out if you have a business question, inquiry, response, your video request, all my social media subscription. Twitter's the best way, then Facebook, then Instagram. Facebook group link in the description as well, too. You can reach out anytime. Whenever you want to reach out for a business question, advertising, business channel, whatever it may be, want to make a financial donation, Cash App, CJGood313. That's the description, PayPal link there as well, too. Best way to donate, share the video. But hey, let me know what you guys think. Shout out to the Suns and Brooklyn for winning. I think Brooklyn's going to sweep. Peace.